sorry it's been such a long time since my last video. I'm going to be quite distracted in this video because I've got both kids at home today. My daughter's normally at preschool on a Monday and a Tuesday, Wednesday, but she's off today. So yeah, at the moment I am currently 16 weeks and 3 days pregnant. I can't remember how many weeks I was when I last filmed my video. I think it was about a month ago, maybe. Not quite a month ago. No, it was a month ago. It's December now. I'm thinking it's November. Yeah. So it was quite a few weeks ago since my last video. But I just wanted to come in here and sort of update you on how I've been feeling and how the hematoma is doing. I don't think I updated. I can't remember if I updated on my 13-week scan, but I'll talk about that briefly as well, just in case I haven't updated that. My YouTube. I'll try and keep it brief because I don't want to go on and on. And there's not much to really talk about, to be honest. There's not a lot of symptoms I've been having. I've actually been forgetting about the pregnancy. Like, I think it's because I'm so busy with the two other children who are very young still. And just a lot of stuff's been going on. We've been ill constantly. Since the end of November, we've just been like going downhill with illness, one after the other. So I haven't really been thinking much about being pregnant, which makes the time go quite quick. Sometimes I think about, oh, I'm only this much pregnant, but I'm kind of trying to deal with, obviously being a mum of two, they're both going through stages at the moment where they're quite grumpy. And, you know, I'm just enjoying being pregnant because this could be our last pregnancy, we just don't know. So yeah, I'll talk about my symptoms first, and then update on the 13-week scan, and then when my next scan is, and also I had a consultant appointment as well. I think it was the week after my 13-week scan, so I'll talk about that. Really haven't been very much. I mean, I've been sick quite a lot this pregnancy, and it seems to be lasting a long time. It's not constant, it's on and off, but when I feel sick, it comes on very quick, and then I am sick. With my son, it was very like stop and start, and I wasn't really sick with him. I kind of felt sick, but then it would go away. But this time I have to be sick in order to feel better, and then I feel better, and then I can sort of start eating again. But so this time, I don't know if it's related to the cold, really, really bad cold I've just got. I'm still getting over, I've still got a bunged up like head, I've still got a bit of sinus pressure and stuff. I have an appointment next week. It just in case the headache doesn't go away, because I don't want it to get worse and worse. So yeah, I'm getting over a cold at the moment. I've had it for over 2 weeks and I'm still bunged up now. So it's a really nasty cold that the kids had. My daughter's actually ill again, and both my children are ill again. So I'm hoping I don't come down with yet another cold, but I probably will because I'm home all day with them. So it's kind of inevitable, but yeah, it's probably like once a week now that I feel sick, but I don't know. I think that's related more to the cold rather than like being pregnant. Because when you have a cold, obviously you have a lot of mucus, and I feel like that is literally making me feel so sick that I have to be sick. And it's like TMI, it's mucus, it's not really sick. It's like mucus coming up. But I haven't had that in about a week. I think the last time was about a week ago, so it's getting fewer and far between my nausea, like throwing up episodes, but I have had it quite a lot this pregnancy. Similar to my daughter, which makes me feel like I'm having a girl. I don't know the gender, obviously, because I'm 16 weeks at the moment. I'm not having a gender scan. We just can't really stretch money-wise that far this time. It's been such an expensive year, so we've decided to wait. See how we feel when it comes to the 20-week scan, and if we want to know, then we'll find out then. If not, we'll wait, because I'll talk about this later on as well. I do have some other scans not booked yet, but they're going to be booked, so we could find out at any point really in this pregnancy if we wanted to. Other symptoms, tiredness is a big one. Like, I'm always tired. I think that's related to the weather. It's coming up to winter, it's dark, it's cold, it's horrible outside all the time, it gets dark really early. I feel like there's not a lot of daylight, to be honest. So I've been really, really tired. My children sleep really well. I'm really lucky. touch wood, they have been sleeping quite well, apart from a couple of days when my son just didn't really want to sleep and he's caught and he's kind of been going through, he's not been well, his teeth are really bad, so it's a lot of things that it could be that why he's not sleeping. And my daughter's been up with a cough last night, but she managed to sleep quite well actually. So yeah, I think it's to do with the constant illness at the moment and just how cold and miserable the weather is, as well as being pregnant and looking after two children. Especially with the school runs, I find my daughter's at preschool 3 days, 2.5 days a week, and I find that exhausting, like the getting both kids ready in the morning, rushing around, and then I panic that I'm going to be late. But she's only got 2 more days, and she's got a Christmas party this Friday, so, and that's her last kind of day. So she's got 2 full days left until Christmas holidays. And then I don't know when she goes back after all that, but yeah, so those are the two other, like, main symptoms I've been having. I haven't been having any pain, apart from like sometimes if I wake up in the night or in the morning, I get a bit of pain if I've been lying on my back and I try and sit up. And also if I need the loo really bad, like if I need to pee really bad, I get like my uterus will just feel so heavy and uncomfortable. But that's normally in the night. But any other times I don't really have feel any pressure or any pain. I feel like my bump is really, really high up this time. I don't feel as big as I was with my son, which makes me feel like I'm having a go again, because I was less, I had less of a bump with my daughter than with my son. It was just absolutely mammoth huge. He was quite a big boy. He was almost 9 pounds, but then he was a week and a half overdue. So other symptoms, I don't really have any other symptoms, to be honest. A bit dizzy, but I think that's due to the sinus pressure and pain I'm having at the moment. Baby brain, I can't seem to get my words out properly, as you probably realise. And I'm confused a lot, and I'm really irritable. Like, I'm really, really irritable. The kids have been quite difficult. And my mood isn't really helping that. So they're picking up on my mood, and then they're being difficult, and then I'm just kind of getting really stressed and really irritable. I think it's because of constant illness. You know, it's not nice to be constantly ill, and having the kids being constantly ill as well. Just the time of year, it's just not very pleasant. But we're looking forward to Christmas. Hopefully we're not going to be ill at Christmas, but I don't know. Having 2 kids under three. It's, you know, you just can't help it if they do get sick, they get sick. 10-week appointment, was I 13 weeks? I think I was 12 weeks, 6 days actually, when I had that appointment. Because my due date changed to a day before when I thought it was. I thought my due date was the 25th of May next year, obviously. But now it's the 24th of May, so I was actually, my weeks turn over on the Friday, which is actually quite exciting, I don't know why. But just the whole earlier, being earlier than I thought, being more pregnant than I thought, even if it's just one day. I don't know, that could change again, I think. But that went fine, that went really well, it was really quick. I'll insert a picture actually in this video, and probably at the end. We just got one picture, so, you know, we have to pay for the pictures, and they all look pretty much the same anyway, so we got one picture. No problems, touch wood, everything looked fine. I still feel like I'm having a go, I don't know. Just the shape of the skull, I'm kind of all into the skull theory, like literally just obsessing over it a little bit. Not so much now, when I first got it done I was obsessing a little bit over it. But I feel like it's a go, but I don't know. I could be surprised. I really want a surprise, I don't really want to find out at my 20 week scan. I was going to have a gender scan, but then I thought, okay, money, you can't really afford it money-wise, because on top of Christmas and everything, and both our kids have just been christened, and then we've had our wedding this year as well, and our honeymoon, and we've moved flat as well. We're in our new flat. Well, we've been here 6 months almost. So it's just been, we just can't stretch for that, and there's no point. I mean, it's 4 weeks until we can find out at our 20-week scan, so there's no point paying. Even though I love the experience of finding out the gender and everything, we might as well just wait till 20 weeks if we want to get it done. But I'm thinking of having a surprise, just because I found out with both of my children. With my daughter, I actually didn't have a gender scan. I found out when I went in for some pain I was having. I was about 17 weeks then, and I said, I asked them if they could tell what it was, and he said, I think it's a girl, but I can't be sure until you're like further along. But yeah, it was right, it was a girl. And then with my son, I had a gender scan. If you look through my videos, you'll see my video with my son, who's, you can see right there. He's almost 14 months now, which is insane. It's just gone really quick. But yeah, so this time I don't really want to have one done because I have experience of having one. I know what it's like to have one. I kind of want to have a surprise because I've not had a surprise before. So I had a consultant appointment at, I think I was about 13 weeks and 6 days or something like that. It was like a week later. And that was very quick. She basically just went over like my history, and then she said stuff about my weight. I'm not underweight. I'm slightly underweight, but I'm the kind of the really low level, low end of normal. So they like to monitor me with scans when I hit 28 weeks, and then 32, and then 36. Just because I tend to have quite big babies. My daughter measured 9 pounds, but she wasn't. She was 7'15". But then I had her like a few days early, not quite 40 weeks. I had her at like 30, 39 plus 5 or something, or 6. I think it was 39 plus 6 or 5, yeah. And with my son, he came a week and a half later and he was almost 9 pounds. So they just like to monitor me because I'm quite small and I have bigger babies. I don't think that's an issue. They just like to take the precaution of keeping an eye on the baby and me, which I don't mind. I don't mind having extra scans, absolutely not. I love having scans, it's reassurance, you know, especially later on in the pregnancy when you don't get any with the NHS normally. So to be monitored, to have more scans, I'm not complaining. Not that I would want to be high risk and have more scans, of course I'm not, but I'm not classed as high risk anyway. I'm kind of just, they're just keeping an eye on things, so hopefully I'll get the letter for the 28 week one, obviously after my 20 week one, because it's quite a long time after the 20 weeks scan. My 20 week scan is the 6th of January, so there's not long to wait at all really. I'm 17 weeks on Friday. So yeah, only a handful of weeks really until my 20 week scan, and I'm really excited but nervous because I'm always nervous about, you know, detailed scans that I do because of potential problems, things can go wrong, but hopefully everything's fine, fingers crossed everything's fine. And then I have another consultant appointment when I'm 28 weeks, and I think by then I will probably have had my 28 week scan, growth scan. I've had growth scans in all of my pregnancies, not just this one. I had them with my daughter, I had quite a few of her because she was measuring big, and then my son, I had quite a few with him. Two or three, I think I had about two with him. And then this one as well, they want to just check the baby's growth. I have a midwife appointment also this Wednesday, my 16 week appointment, and that's just standard. I think it's going to be the same midwife that I had with both kids, apart from the same midwife I had with my son, but with my daughter I saw her at the beginning, but then I moved area, so I saw a different midwife, whom I didn't really like. But now I'm back with the one I saw with Max, so that's going to be quite nice. Just seeing the same lady, I'm familiar with her, and it's in the same place that I saw, that I was seeing when I had Max. So yeah, that's basically it. It's a pregnancy update. I don't really have anything else to update on until after my midwife. So I'm going to do a bump shot. I haven't done one in this pregnancy yet, I don't think. So I'm going to do one now. But yeah, this is my 16 week and 3 days bump. It'd be quite interesting to go back and see what I looked like with my son when I was 16 weeks, because it's on my YouTube channel if anyone's interested in having a look to see how big I was with him. But I don't feel as big this time, and I feel like my bump is like quite high. It kind of just under my boobs. It kind of goes around. Whether that before, I think with my daughter it sloped down and it was big like out here. Now it's kind of out like this, and it was kind of like this with my son as well. Thanks for watching this video. Hope it wasn't too rambly. I'm just trying to quickly get in a video so that I have some like what's been going on up documented, because I've been looking through and I haven't really been documenting much about this pregnancy. Probably because I just tend to just get on with things and I don't really think about it as much as I did with my daughter and my son. Not in a bad way, it's just being busy and being ill all the time. It's a struggle, but yeah, I will update next, probably my 20-week scan, because then I can just do it all together instead of every week. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.